going on, everyone? Welcome to a brand new movie review. Today, I'm going to be discussing Miss Bala. If you guys are new here, consider hitting that like and subscribe button because this is where you guys can get some early movie reviews, early movie news, and any sort of geeky content. Plus, you guys can also check out Sandwich on Films down below for advanced movie screenings. Miss Bala stars Gina Rodriguez as a great lady who is a makeup artist in LA. She heads back to Tijuana, her hometown, to hang out with her friend who is gonna go into the Miss Baja California modeling show. But along the way, they happen to go to a club to get some dancing going, and a shootout happens. And Gina Rodriguez's character ends up going between the cartel and the DEA. Hear me out. I actually thought the trailer was actually pretty decent. It kind of got my intrigue. And I was like, this looks good. But it can also turn out to have a Twilight and 50 Shades feel. Just not with vampires and a crazed sex man. The film actually might have been better if it introduced vampires or a crazed sex man. Before I really get into this film, I want you guys to know, I don't like crapping on movies. I don't like sitting there talking bad about a movie because I know it takes so much time to develop, produce, and make one of these films. But one of the big pros I can actually say about this film is Gina Rodriguez. Two big thumbs up for her overall. She was excellent in here, and I really want to see her actually leading a better made film because her performance in here is not just outstanding, she is fantastic in here, to the point where she was actually overacting into the film and the film felt not able to keep up with her. Because a lot of the reasons that I had problems with this film wasn't because of the performances from our lead actors and actresses, because again, Gina Rodriguez is the big standout of this whole film and everyone else in here does a decent job. The film falters due to the fact that it's just super generic. It's predictable to all ends. Once you actually get into the story of the drug cartel and the DEA going around in Gina Rodriguez's life, you find yourself being able to pick apart and guess where things, certain things are going to happen. You're completely right on when those things and issues happen. Twist every turn, you know exactly where it's going to go. Holy isn't original. I've seen some of these concepts done better within other films that tackled the drug cartel. The type of dialogue in this film just doesn't hit that substance that this film deserves. Here's the thing, there's a lot of great issues that this film raises that are happening over in Mexico that I've seen in other films tackled 10 times better. This film tackles them, but in a very lightweighty kind of way. I understand this is a movie and this is made for my entertainment, but in the fact that I wasn't entertained, this film tries to be dramatic, overly dramatic at times, to the point where it comes off melodramatic, and to the point where it also feels like a TV film. Sometimes it tries to turn into an action film, and the action scenes aren't particularly shot well. They're very shaky, and I don't understand what the hell's going on, and it feels like it was edited down to a PG-13 instead of an R rating. Besides just a couple of moments in here where I smirked or smiled, or even said, hey, that's Gina Rodriguez, and she's being pretty big badass in that scene. Myself, again, just finding myself checking the time, wondering where it's gonna end, knowing how it's gonna end because I'm predicting the whole thing. If I'm being honest, the only thing I did not predict in the whole film was the ending. Well, I did predict the ending, but they actually set up for a sequel in this film. They set up for a sequel. Miss Bala does not need a sequel. Before I get to my final thoughts, guys, make sure to comment down below and let me know what your guys' thoughts are on Miss Bala. Were you guys looking forward to this film? Have you seen it already? Let's talk about it down below. If you guys like this film, I want to hear your guys' thoughts down below so we can have a great conversation because I love hearing different opinions about film. Miss Bala, again, stars Gina Rodriguez, who gets two big thumbs up for me. She was excellent in here, and I really enjoyed her performance in here, and I really hope she can get and land another leading role into a film. She was great in Annihilation last year. I know she's great in the shows and everything else that she's been in so far, and again, excellent in here, just doesn't, the film cannot hold up to her standards. The film can't decide what its tone wants to be. Does it want to be an action film? Does it want to be kind of a sexy romance and the drug cartel twist and turns thriller seduction film? Or does it want to be a melodramatic or even a drama for its sake? It doesn't know what it wants to be. The dialogue doesn't know where to take it. Sometimes it's cheesy, sometimes it's not. And it, even if it was cheesy, if it knew what it was is, or it was trying to be different by maybe adding a sex craze fiend or vampires to it, maybe it would have been better. When films shoot for the stars and maybe don't land, but I can at least appreciate it for that manner. This film doesn't. It just feels like a normal, typical Hollywood film that's churned out and lazily directed, lazily written, and maybe just put out there to have a sequel set up towards the end. So like, hey, if it does make money, we can make another one. For me, Miss Bala is the worst film so far of this year. it not at one point did it pick me up and perk me up to be able to recommend it. Maybe you'll catch it on VOD or streaming and you might actually enjoy it better than I did. But it's hard for me to say, hey, go spend your hard-earned cash to go see this film. With all that said, I'm going to give Miss Bala a D+. Like, again, that I mentioned, I don't like talking bad about movies, but this movie just did not work for me. Again, guys, let me know what your guys' thoughts are on this film. Did you guys like it? Did you hate it? I'm curious to hear your guys' thoughts. And if you guys loved it, I want to hear about it down below. Plus, let me know, what should Gina Rodriguez do next? Because I'm looking forward to it. Guys, hit that like and subscribe button. Check out Sandwich on Films. See you guys soon. Stay classy. We'll be right back.